Uni Abuja invaders demand 300 million naira for abducted professors' family members. You find this story on page 9. I mean, we talked about this and we said it seems like it's coming home.
It is, by every means. I mean, we saw the Uni Abuja raid. They took the professor, took his son, took one of them. At the end of the day, they've established contact and asking for 300
million.
These are the bandits, criminal terrorists ravaging the north. They have arrived very close to Abuja and they have brought their attitude, their practice to that place. And that wasn't just the story, because another secondary school in Abuja yesterday, the bandit arrived in school and took the vice principal. So what we're saying is that it used to be in Niger State, it used to be in Zamfara, it used to be in Kaduna. Katsina was their hub. But they've arrived very close to the federal capital now, So I hear that there are very major security operations ongoing in the FCT. Throughout yesterday, the roadblocks and the patrol were very high, caused major traffic in the city. Because the authorities know that if these bandits are already raiding the rest of Abuja and Gwagwalada, then they're very close. They're very close. Something has to be done. Otherwise, if Abuja is not safe, where is
it? Where is safe?
In this country, really. And the bandits are so brazen. They are bold. I mean, they went into the University of Abuja, took the professors, they already did it. And they did this for hours, very close to a military battalion, not far away. And they keep doing this, very close to security agencies, like, come and catch us if you can.
So what exactly are the security operatives doing?
The question I ask, usually you're afraid to carry out criminal activities near security agencies because they will catch you. If you run, they will follow you, they will be on your trail until they catch you. But these bandits have even entered the NDA in the past.
Spend hours, walk on motorcycles and
kill people. Wow. So, Abuja is a small fry compared to what they can do or what they have shown that they can do.
All right, Ekiti woman jailed 10 years for assaulting pregnant neighbor, forcing labor. You find the story on page 38. Subsidy payments cost 864.07 billion naira in 9 months. You find the story on page 29. This is according to NNPC,
When I was in school, I hate mathematics because I don't get a grasp of numbers. But this one that I'm doing with this subsidy, even mathematicians do not understand it. Even professors of maths will be confused with the way they dish out the numbers. One official will say this amount, another official will say that
it's
amount. An NNPC document, PPRA, PPMC, all the agencies under the NNPC, all of them, they have their own different figures as to how much subsidy costs, how much it will cost, how much it can cost. They also have different figures of how much petrol we consume daily. Different. The NNPC GMB will give his own. The PPMC will give their own. Petrol market, everybody. It's just a myriad of confusion, which everybody will tell you is mad in corruption. Really. This subsidy business has to end. I don't know how the government wants to end it. If they will offend Nigerians who carry placards, I don't know, but this amount of money is too much. A country that's about to spend 1 trillion in 9 months on subsidy. It's not a serious country. Something that's avoidable. And the question has been, how do we not pay subsidy?
Yes.
Fix our refineries, ensure that we do not buy what we have. And this has been a very difficult venture for the government to undertake. So we'll all wait for Mr. Dangote now in 2022 to start his refinery, so that the government can have the courage to end the subsidy regime. Because if they attempt it today, going by market dynamics, petrol will probably be around 350 per liter. I'm not sure Nigerians can take that.
This time.
You can buy gas 7-8, because you can use the gas for a month. But you know how much petrol we're spending. Yesterday I bought fuel twice for my generator, twice.
This generator, yeah,
because the kids are home now for midterm break, and there's no power at all. And these kind kids of nowadays, they don't like darkness for 1 hour.
At all.
They will say, I have homework. And it's internet. So it's just that's the truth. A lot of people are spending a lot. Income has remained stagnant. So if you go and increase petrol price now, say you're removing subsidy, I'm sure that the reaction of somebody will like it. But the government also have to come clean about this on that report. It boggles the mind when they mention this large amount as how much is being spent on subsidy. Because the calculations, the maths don't add up. It doesn't matter. No matter how you try to calculate it, it doesn't really give you a sense of this is the amount. Again, that's why the question has been asked, how much do we consume in this country daily? Demi Presilva said it was around 40 to 50 million. The GMD says 30 million. The PPMC said 60 million liters per day.
Did you enjoy this video?
Hit the subscribe button for more, leave a comment, and like. Thank you.